Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. And this is lecture number 5 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. The topic for the discussion is Isentropic Flow in Nozzle and Diffuser, Part 1. We recap from the earlier lecture. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the stagnation properties, relationship between stagnation and the static properties for the isentropic flow, Mach number and reference velocities, and the effect of Mach number on the compressibility. And the topic for today's discussion is governing equation for isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser and the relationship between various properties. The learning outcome to the students: the students will be able to write the relationship between stagnation static properties, static to critical properties, stagnation to critical properties at the end of the lecture. Isentropic flow through variable area duct. And this is the variable area duct. The area for the flow is constantly decreasing in this diagram. And for the general statement, for variable area, the cross-sectional area for the flow may increase or decrease. And we have two sections, inlet and the outlet section. Section 1 is inlet, section 2 is outlet. So here we have the properties: pressure P1, temperature T1, velocity C1, area A1, density ρ1, and Mach number M1. Similarly, at the outlet section, we have the properties P2, T2, C2, A2, M2, and ρ2. Now we are going to determine the properties between inlet and the outlet for isentropic flow in the variable area duct. The governing equation for isentropic flow, we have P by rho to the power gamma equal to constant. So isentropic flow, earlier we discussed, the flow which is reversible adiabatic is called as isentropic flow. So for reversible flow, there is no frictional losses, and adiabatic flow, there is no heat transfer. That is why the area, the nozzle, or the diagram, here we have the hatches. This is insulation. The area, the outer body, the control volume, outer surface of the device, the duct is insulated. So the flow becomes adiabatic, and we assume there is no frictional losses for the flow inside the duct. So the flow becomes isentropic flow. For isentropic flow, in thermodynamics, we studied PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So we represent in terms of density P by rho to the power gamma equal to constant. And the acoustic velocity A1 is square root of gamma R T1, and acoustic velocity the outlet A2 equal to square root of gamma R T2. So this equation, acoustic velocity, also we defined in the earlier lecture. Now the relationship between inlet and the outlet properties for isentropic flow, T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is also equal to rho 2 by rho 1 to the power gamma minus 1. And acoustic velocity A2 by A1 equal to, from the earlier definition A1 and A2, A2 by A1 equal to T2 by T1 to the power 1 by 2, which is P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by 2 gamma, and rho 2 by rho 1 to the power gamma minus 1 by 2. So these are all the relationship between the properties between inlet and the outlet. Now relationship between inlet and the outlet properties in terms of Mach number. We derive the properties relationship in terms of Mach number from the adiabatic energy equation. So we have, for adiabatic flow, enthalpy remains constant. So HO1 equal to HO2. This also we discussed earlier in the previous lecture. So HO1 equal to HO2, the stagnation enthalpy remains constant for variable area duct isentropic flow. So we have, for gas, H equal to Cp into T. So HO1 equal to HO2, we can write as, in terms of temperature, TO1 equal to TO2. From the earlier definition, the TO1, the stagnation temperature, is the static temperature into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square. And similarly, TO2, stagnation temperature at the outlet, T2 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 into M2 square. So rearranging the terms, T2 by T1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m2 square. So this is the relationship between T2 and T1, the temperature between inlet and the outlet in terms of Mach number, where M1 is the Mach number at the inlet of the inlet section and the M2 is the Mach number at the outlet section of the device. Now similarly P2 by P1, earlier we said P2 by P1 equal to T2 by T1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma by gamma minus 1. Now we substitute for T2 by T1. So T2 by T1 in terms of Mach number, 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square whole to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. Similarly the density, ratio of density rho 2 by rho 1 equal to T2 by T1 to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So we can write, substitute in terms of temperature. So rho 2 by rho 1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. Now the relationship between pressure, temperature and density in terms of Mach number between inlet and the outlet section, they are given here. Now the relationship between stagnation static properties in terms of Mach number. So these are all the relationship between stagnation static properties in terms of Mach number. This already we discussed in the first introductory lecture, the stagnation properties TO by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square. PO by P equal to TO by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1, which is 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. And rho by rho equal to TO by T to the power 1 by gamma minus 1, which is 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So this relationship already we discussed in the introductory lecture or the earlier chapter. Relationship between stagnation and the static properties. Now relationship between critical and static properties. Now relationship between temperature at the inlet and the outlet. So this is what we derived earlier. T2 by T1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square. Now consider the flow is decelerated to critical Mach number. So critical Mach number equal to 1 at the outlet. Critical Mach number at the outlet, that is M2 becomes 1. So denominator M2 becomes 1 and the T2 becomes T star, the star stands for critical property, the T2 become critical temperature. So in the equation, we have to substitute T2 equal to T star and M2 equal to 1. We take T1 equal to T and M1 equal to M. So T2 become T star and T1 become T. And the numerator 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2, M1 becomes M square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square, M2 equal to 1, so 1 square equal to 1. So the numerator as it is 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square divided by denominator, simplifying the denominator it becomes gamma plus 1 by 2. Now here I take T star by T equal to, I take the denominator to the numerator, so 2 by gamma plus 1 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square. Now finally T star by T equal to, I take 2 by gamma plus 1 into the bracket. So 2 by gamma plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square. So T star is the critical property where the Mach number equal to 1. T is the static properties at the inlet of the section. When the outlet section is critical, this is the relationship between critical temperature and the static temperature of the inlet. So T star by T equal to 2 by gamma plus 1. Plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square. Similarly, other properties A star by A equal to T star by T to the power 1 by 2. So this becomes substituting for T star by T 2 by gamma plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square to the power 1 by 2. P star by P equal to T star by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. Substituting for T by T star 2 by gamma plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. Rho star by rho equal to T star by T to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. Substituting for T star by T equal to 2 by gamma plus 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So these are all the relationship between critical temperature and the static temperature. Critical properties and the static properties. The relationship between critical and stagnation properties. So we have TO by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square. Now, consider the flow is decelerated to critical Mach number m equal to 1, then t become t star. So when m equals, so in this equation you substitute m equal to 1 and t equal to t star. So t o by t star equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is gamma plus 1 by 2. 1 plus gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 by 2 is equal to gamma plus 1 by 2. And the t star by t o equal to reciprocal 2 by gamma plus 1. So t star is the critical temperature, t o is the stagnation temperature, which is 2 by gamma plus 1. And similarly, other properties, A star by AO equal to T star by TO, which is to the power 1 by 2. So, 2 by gamma plus 1 to the power 1 by 2. P star by PO equal to T star by TO to the power gamma by gamma minus 1, which is 2 by gamma plus 1 to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. Rho star by rho equal to T star by TO to the power 1 by gamma minus 1, which is 2 by gamma plus 1 to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So, these are the relationship between critical and the stagnation properties. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book. You may refer to the book for additional information on the subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the YouTube channel, listen to the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comment box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or email ID for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again another lecture on the isentropic flow through variable area duct. Until then, bye.